Hi to all, welcome to HEFS channel. Today we are discussing about EHS guidelines to restart operations and succeed post lockdown. So what is the environment health and safety special precautions during COVID-19 and after post lockdown, what is the role of environment health and safety professional, health and safety professional and all facilities managers and admin staff and safety managers. So what is the exactly EHS guidelines to restart the operations very smoothly for this, especially in COVID-19. So today we are discussing for that, you know, there is a environment health and safety, the lot of departments including for this guidelines. So in this scenario we have discussion mainly department wise. Number one, security, technical department and soft services and facilities management, administrative staff, building management and electrical team, technical team, fire and safety team and maintenance and engineering team and pest control team, F&B managers, so and safety and security. So everybody is involved after post lockdowns accordingly EHS guidelines, which is given that as per government norms and World Health Organization norms. So I had taken that World Health Organization references for this every guidelines. So let us start today for that EHS guidelines for safe work environment while entering that inside the facility. So for this mainly we have focused, let us follow the safety guidelines for all the times. Regularly measure and monitor your body temperature, carry home food as much as possible, wear mask at all times, carry your own water bottle and glass, avoid wearing accessories and jewelries, carry your sanitizer and as per government norms you can be upload Arogya Setu app, and you after uploading that Arogya Setu you can be find out that your nearest red zone, green zone and orange zone. So accordingly you have to alert and inform to your colleagues and team to better to safe environment. And coming to that, so for this you have to involve in self inspection, uniform, safety shoes, ID card and COVID-19 PPE is mandatory. Maintain social distancing or physical distancing and enter the facility as per security protocol. Attend toolbox meeting before starting the work. So whatever the discussions is there in toolbox, whatever you have to design as per the schedule, you can discuss with your team, that is called the toolbox meeting before starting the work. And also use PPEs, personal protective equipments, as per the work permit and the nature of the work. And frequent sanitize washing of hands. Do not enter the workplace immediately and check for proper lighting and fresh air circulation. Place appropriate warning signage and barricades at the work areas. Ensure proper sanitized and insulated tools. Report if any abnormality to the supervisor. Update the checklist work completion report after completing the task. So Coming to that, what is the exactly guidelines for the security team? So check on the every point to point for that whoever enter the service partners or employees into the facility for their safety and security. So you can be seek the support for technical and smart hygiene solution staff is required. So while opening of office, closed rooms, avoid entering the immediately and wait for fresh air circulation. You can check for all keys, master keys, for enough lighting and ventilation, CCTV, access controls and communication devices like walkie-talkies, telephones and public address system, PA systems. All access doors are functioning and not jammed. Just check it, and you can check the all emergency door is open and free for movement. You can check the signages of different zones and unauthorized area access should be installed. Sanitization station is having enough stock, and you can check the working of fire alarm and fighting systems. And also you can maintain the physical distance to be maintained with the necessary markings. Whatever you can marking that your area, so your security team is following the social distance or not. And you can check and allow only employees and service partners with valid ID cards and after screening for temperature. Check all that high level personal hygiene. Check all that personal belongings and bags as per the security protocol guidelines, and maintain a proper record of visitors and other people entering the facility, and ensure that all the workers are having a valid work permit, warning signages, barricades, PPEs, safety norms being followed as per their work. In case any deviations or abnormality, report to superiors immediately. So plan for fire evacuation drill as part of the security protocol and as per that government norms. Record and update the activities, incidents, accidents according to your supervisor and client. So there are all that you can use for that security checks in your area. So whoever that symptoms is there, you can inform to immediately your concerned supervisor. If anything positive is there, you can immediately inform to supervisor, then they have to immediately inform to local authority. They will come and they will be take for that immediate address for that. So initial address is the security is the main focus and main checks for this control method. And coming to that, what is the guidelines for that smart hygiene solutions? What exactly is smart hygiene? So they have to pick round for all these areas and checking for that all facilities, clearing for all any abnormalities, and how to check for any abnormalities is there, you can free movement. Seek the support of technical team and security personnel if required. You can check and ensure proper lighting or ventilation and before entering the workplace. So check stocks and expiry of pantry consumables, cleaning materials, chemicals, disinfectants, toiletries or PPEs. And refer that MSDS manual before handling any new chemicals or equipments. Color code mops and dusters to prevent cross contaminations. So you can check for color code mops and dusters also. And you can check sanitize all cleaning tools and touch points before starting the operations. It is suggested to do away bucket mopping system to move into smart cleaning for better hygiene. All stairs are free for movement of people and materials. You can check for that all staircases, you can check for that handrails, you can check for that every part of that wherever the dirty particle is, you have to clear and as per that cleaning schedule. And you can check that water dispenser are washed or are dirty, or is it filled with fresh water or not. And you can check for abnormalities like water stagnation or leakages or cloggings or foul smells or dead pests or garbage and scrap. And you can functioning of that exhausting is in washroom or not. Just check for that. It's a very, very important checkpoints. So, and you can check for water flow in that facets and EWC and urinals. And you can record and update the activities, incidents according to your supervisor, client and as per that EHS standards. And coming to that, what is that EHS and safety guidelines for biomedical and hazardous and e-waste management in your facilities? So you can checkpoints is coming to that, you can check and ensure proper lighting and ventilation before entering that wastage yard. Ensure appropriate PPE before handling any waste. You can check and ensure proper labeling and coloring of bins. You place closed and dedicated bin for disposing COVID-19. PPEs spray disinfected into the bin on hourly basis to sanitize the stored waste. Segregate waste at source. Always use trolleys or auto bins for portioning of wastage. You can segregate for that dry wastage and wet wastage, biomedical wastage, e-wastage, as per that solid waste management and biomedical wastage management rules and regulations. Use service lift to transport waste. Store collected waste at the designated area. Dispose of hazardous electronic waste to PCB authorized vendor. PCB means Pollution Control Board authorized vendor. And you can dispose of biomedical waste as per that Pollution Control Board and Hospital Infection Control Team guidelines and BMW guidelines. You can sanitize garbage trolley, elevator, post disposal. You can thoroughly elevator also, you can clear for that what after dispose that wastage, you can clean and thoroughly clean and sanitize your elevator area, and wash and sanitize hands post handling waste. So you can all records and update activities incidents according to your supervisor and clients. So next, coming to that, what is the guidelines for that maintenance and engineering service team or M&E team? So it's a very, very important before operation of engineering equipment for safe working atmosphere. You can check for all the points. You can take the support from security and what is that technology is there. You can incorporate this technology and what is smart hygiene solutions for this COVID-19 control methods. So you can go for that. When you go for that, enter the DG room. What exactly checkpoints, let us discuss. So you can entry for authorized persons only. So before entry for that, you can check for that your hand sanitations and your social distances, and you can without touching for any equipments or tools, and you have to wear the PPEs. So entry for authorized persons only, you just follow for that. You can check and ensure proper lighting and ventilations, okay, and follow the lockout and tagout procedure, and check fuel, all filters, coolant, oil, air vents, hose and gaskets, battery voltage. Check electrical connections and make sure they are tight or properly connected or not. You can run DG on manual mode with no load and observe for any abnormality. Oil pressure, coolant temperature and battery run voltage, fuel leak, belt tension, air filter indicator and noise level. And you can check and ensure the condition of firefighting equipment and the equipment are in place. रिमूव ऑल वेस्टेज एंड कीप इट एसेट फॉर सेफ एंड डिस्पोजल एंड ऑल्सो रिकॉर्ड एंड अपडेट द एक्टिविटीज इंसिडेंट्स अकॉर्डिंग टू योर सुपरवाइजर एंड क्लाइंट. सो कमिंग टू दैट इलेक्ट्रिकल पैनल रूम. सो इन इलेक्ट्रिकल पैनल रूम इन दिस एरिया यू कैन चेक फॉर दैट सेम व्हेवर ऑथराइज्ड पर्सन्स ओनली हैव अलाउड एंड यू कैन चेक फॉर दैट लाइटिंग एंड वेंटिलेशंस एंड यू कैन चेक फॉलो दैट लॉकआउट एंड टैगआउट प्रोसीजर एंड इट इज़ वेरी हेल्प फॉर दैट टू प्रिवेंट द इलेक्ट्रिकल शॉक एंड इलेक्ट्रोक्यूशन रिजल्टिंग फ्रॉम स्टोर्ड एनर्जी. सो यू कैन चेक एंड एनश्योर फॉर दैट इलेक्ट्रिकल सेफ्टी मैट्स आर इन प्लेस आर नॉट एंड पीपी इज अवेलेबल आर नॉट. First aid kit is available or not. In that first aid kit is that all material is there or not. Who can using or who are not using. Wherever a high level touching points is there. Panel touching points before cleaning or after cleaning. You can check for each and every year. There is no wet areas and rust particles and corrosion. You can check for that no evidence of overheating. No improper wiring or damaged equipment. No unprotected panel opening or unlabeled circuit and no pest damage. Do not continue to touch or inspect a panel if you sense a charge, tingle or shock. And you can check and ensure the condition of firefighting equipment, the equipment are in place. Same to be record and update all activities for this panel room area and whatever incidents or any near misses, any activities or a major or minor, you can be record and update accordingly and you have to inform to your supervisor and client as per that EHS standards. So coming to that boiler operations in this same maintenance and engineering section, same here also you can entry for authorized persons, you can check for that lighting and ventilation. And you same to be follow that lot of procedure and same to you have to check for that boiler area or room is cleaned or free from litter or safety valves or function and must test that safety feature on a boiler and water level control and low water fuel cutoff. Aware of many hard surfaces in a boiler. A rigorous leak check program to be implemented as a part of the owner's preventive maintenance program. So the valve positions are correct to start the operations. Never enter the boiler until an adequate cool off period has been observed and the operator's entry procedures have been completed. And you can check and ensure the condition of firefighting equipment, the equipment are in place or not. And same too, you can record for all incident and accident inform to supervisor as per EHS standards. And next another area, you can check for transformer. It's a very very main area. The transformer safety tips, any model or electrical transformer, or any regardless of make or manufacturing, you can follow for that safety tips. Entry for authorized persons. And check and ensure proper lighting and ventilation if indoor. In case indoor, you can check the lighting and ventilations. And follow the lockout and tagout procedure. Check and everything before operations. You can check and ensure before operations. For this, use appropriate PPE to carry out the pre-check. Transformer area is cleaned and free from litter. Oil level. Ventilation fan, vibration and electrical terminal, no burning smell, faulty parts or abnormalities, grounding should always be in place, condition of silica gel and color as a blue, inspect to ensure that no foreign nuts, bolts or spare parts have fallen into it. The working condition of tripping mechanism is OLTC. So any maintenance work must be undertaken after the equipment is de-energized and tagged out and the circuit is shut down. Check and ensure the condition availability of firefighting equipment. Must should be follow that firefighting systems in this area. And whoever that operating that technical transformer, technical person, he must and should be the competent, and he must aware about that firefighting technicals and transformer operational and energizing, de-energizing operations. And also same to be whatever the abnormalities is, you have to record and update all activities as per that norms. So another section we'll go for that very important section is the fire pump room. The fire pump room, so every area you have to entry of the authorized is the very very mandatory. Same to be inside, you can check for the lighting and ventilation. Same to be check for your cleaning, are you not free from dust, clean and green and free from environment, is that is called the first priority. Any dust particles is third important. And you can follow that lockout and tagout procedure. And you can check for the daily operation. Before the operation, you can check for that. Use appropriate PPE to carry out in the pre-check. Transformer area is cleaned and free from litter. Fire water sump 100% storage. No water seepage and hazardous materials. Valve positions and electrical panel safety in place. Fuel available in diesel genset pump system. Can conduct pressure test and jockey pump operates. You can check for the hydrant and sprinkler pump is working properly. And you can check for water leakage in hydrant line and sprinkler line. And you can test run 10 minutes and pressure gauge works or not. And you can check and ensure the condition of available of firefighting equipment. So all this, any abnormalities are the same to be, you can check and update as per the checklist or running activities. You can make it in incidents according to your supervisor or your clients as per that EHS standards. So every area, and coming to that very important area, and AHU, air handling unit, so every facilities AHU room is very very important. So for this also, entry for authorized persons only. You can check for proper lighting and ventilation, follow the lockout procedure, and you can check the casing and fan, motor, belt tension, filters, and coiling coils and the thermostats and actuators. So you can check for all equipments, tools, and there is a conditions before the start for operations. Again, you can check and ensure the condition of the firefighting equipment and the equipment are in place. So all should be have to record and update for in AHU room. And coming to that HVAC, chiller and pump operations. Same to be in HVAC, heat and ventilation, air conditioning, and chiller and pump operations. Before start the operation, no entry for the unauthorized persons. Entry for only authorized persons only. You can check for ensure proper lighting and ventilation. Okay, and same to be follow the lockout procedure. You can chiller room specially, you can clean and free from the litter. Same to be check the position of valves and its function. And appropriate pressure of refrigerant and water. And you can check the no refrigerant leak, water leak, and compressor oil leak. Okay, leakage is, you can just, must and should be mandatory, you have to check for that refrigerant leak and water leak and compressor oil leak. And electrical contacts are inspected and cleaned. You can check for operation and pumps and water flow. I can check for set points of chilled water outlet and inlet. Check and ensure the every condition of firefighting and equipment are in place or not. So all these points you can be record and update and as per that client standards and norms. So next, coming to for M&D section, its area is STP or ETP plant, STP and ETP, sewage treatment plant and effluent treatment plant. So every building and every hospitals and all industries, and STP is now mandatory as per that the CPCB and PCB norms. So So in this STP area, when you operate, start the operations, so there is a certain points you have to focus. So common points is that no entry for unauthorized persons, and check and ensure the proper lighting and ventilation inside that area, and all the follow the lockout and tagout rules for this every area. And STP spaces, including wet wells, manholes, dry wells, or any space that is below ground level or has inadequate ventilation, has the potential for containing deadly hydrogen sulfide gas. If the ventilation fan is not present and operating, a personnel should not enter the confined space without an air pack or proper retrieval equipment. So portable ventilation equipment should be readily available for use in case of failure of the normal ventilation equipment. So under no circumstances should be personnel enter a confined space without proper equipment or rescue personnel standing by. So you can check for all these points in precautionary measure against gas hazards. When a sewer or STP manhole is required to be entered in the clearing and obstruction for any maintenance where dangerous gas or oxygen deficiency may be present, the following precautions shall be taken. Adequate ventilation shall be maintained during the work, and the gas test shall be repeated every 3 minutes. Check and ensure the condition of firefighting equipment and the equipment are in place. Same to be recorded all activities and incidents according to your supervisor and client. So let us will discuss for that next topic, for this guidelines for working at height. So you are working at height, what is your precautions you can take in for the, as per HS guidelines. So executive height works within a SOW with proper work permit, and most importantly, safely and of self and others. Seek the support of technical team and security personnel if required, and record and update the activities and incidents according to your supervisors and client. Check, ensure proper lighting and ventilation prior to entering the workplace. You can ensure the right quality of PPE being used. So in this work at height, there is a do's and don'ts is there. So in the do's, I think do ensure the equipment that you are in using for the job is tested for strength or stable or suitable for getting the job done. All work and height is properly planned or organized. A risk assessment to be carried for all work conducted at height. Do as much work as you can while you are on the ground. Do make sure that an employee can safely move to and from the area where they are working at the height. Do be careful when you are working near to a fragile surface. Do not lean or place the ladder or on fragile upper surface. Do ensure that you are protected from falling objects. And don't overload the ladders that you are in working on with equipments or material, and don't try to reach too far when you are in the ladder or step ladder. Don't use ladders or step ladders to do work that entail heavy or strenuous tasks. Only use them to do work that's quick and light. Don't allow incompetent workers to do any work at height without training, without skills. So coming to that pest control guidelines for that, as per EHS norms, you can check for that all proper lighting and ventilation before entering the workplaces. Check stocks or expiry of traps, glue pads and chemicals, PPEs, and you can refer MSDS and manual before handling any new chemicals or equipment. Can sanitize for all cleaning tools and touch points before starting the operations. Check all the areas like cafeteria, pantry, server room, utility area, office area and periphery for any trapped pests, breeding of pests or any foul smell, and share pest control observations or entry points, report with the supervisors and clients. So all this pest control area you can check for this, and before the starting operation you can do for the, if any possible is there, you can do for that COVID-19 control method, for that sterifume treatment for this all areas. I can check for the rodent entry points. You can do conduct the for rodent entry audits, so technical audits, go for that all areas, inside areas and confined space areas as per that EHS guidelines. You can do for that entire clean and green for this with your different treatments of the pest control. So the better idea is EHS guidelines for this must and should be COVID-19 emergency coordinator is mandatory for that every at least every 40 members one emergency coordinator, as well as I think as per that EPRP emergency preparedness response plan and business continuity plan, you can mention for emergency contacts for that fire and police and ambulance and nearest hospitals, and you can be include for that new nearest COVID-19 hospitals and regional HR contact and regional head contacts, so, and you can mention for that nearest COVID-19 coordinator and nearest government local authorities, nearest municipal local authorities, and ambulance number and public numbers, private numbers. You must and should be upload your Arogya Sethu app, and you can be noted for that your supervisor number. So all this you have to noted and alert for that in case of anything deviation happening in your workplace. Same to be have to inform to your supervisors. So these are all mandatory for that environment health and safety guidelines for that as per that World Health Organization norms. So main focus we have to key messages and actions in workplace are all administrators or safety managers. Sick workers or any employee, any other staff should not come to workplace. To promote regular and thorough hand washing by employees, contractors or customers. And workplace should promote physical distancing. Only two worker or employee can do work. Seating arrangement also be spread. So combine with other communication measures such as offering guidance from occupational health and safety officers, the briefings, meetings and information are intranet sites to promote hand washing. So display posters promoting respiratory hygiene combines this other communications measures such as a guidance from occupational health and safety officers, briefing at meetings, information on the intranet. Office rooms and workstations, cabin room temperature should be under 24 to 30 degree temperatures as per that ISHRAE and ASHRAE standards. Mandatory humidity is relative humidity within 40% to 70%. Ensure that face masks, ordinary medical masks rather than N95 masks or paper tissues are available at your workplaces. Who's develop a runny nose or cough work at work along with the closed bins for hygienically dispose of them. So you can must and should be mandatory for the disinfect all the workplace areas, clean and disinfect all disinfect workplace is mandatory. Clean and disinfect workplace area, buildings and especially water and sanitation facilities at least once a day. Particularly surfaces that are touched by many people, chair table, elevator, railings, lunch tables, sports equipment, door and window handles, tools, entrance electronic gate, learning aids, so restricted area, all lab equipment, AC, DVR, NVR, amplifier, any type of controller, fire panel, pump house, fire extinguishers, access reader, so through hydrogen peroxide, so all this sanitizer not applicable for human skin. So the primarily as cleaning and disinfect agent is that you can check for that sodium hypochlorite is they preferred for that as per that government norms, can use for that in every area wherever the high level touching points for the continuously in your workplace area. So sanitizing tunnels it's not recommended for that government, but it will be instead of that sanitizing tunnels, you can use for this hand sanitizing for every person should be, you know, follow for that before start that operations, and mandatory that to keep that in your pocket for that every hand sanitizer for every whatever you're touching that equipments after you can be used for the hand sanitizers, and you can use for this any all these areas. Physical access control systems or card readers or keypads, biometric captures, so devices, so lock doors, so panels and communication systems, so fire and life safety systems, so video surveillance systems, so and perimeter intrusion detection systems, so and network and telecommunication infrastructures and security information and event management. For all this, wherever that you can be alerts for all department heads, their tools and equipments must and should be clean and thoroughly sanitized for that every half an hour or every 1 hour as per the schedule. You can verify all electrical systems or boards or earth pits and inside that boards, distribution boards or switch boards during lockdown, and insects have not got trapped in this electrical apparatus. Maybe if any trapped in that electrical equipments, you can be check for that valves and earth pits inside that. If anything, you can DG rooms or anything you can inside any equipments is there, you know, dust particle is there. You can be check for every area and you can clean for that. And lift after should be strictly use gloves and mask during the duty hours and verify all CCTV systems. And CCTV surveillance is now integral part of the school, college, across the world. Visual inspection of all the components for any kind of damage of loose connections which might have happened during the lockdown period. Verify CCTV video footage of each camera and all the recorders, DVR, NVR servers for last 60 days. Must be implement thermal image scanning, body temperature camera. It can be handheld tripod standing type. The government will ask all major companies that reopen that permit to share their CCTV footage. We will make it mandatory for all bigger organizations to share CCTV footage. We will set up a control room where our industry department will monitor for the feed, ensure the social distancing norms are being followed, said additional chief secretary. So all there, all the statements given the additional secretary, chief secretary, GMDA persons also given the statements for this CCTV rules and regulations. So you can check for the verify PA systems, all this PA system components, any damage or loose connections, you can check for that. And verify fire reduction production systems, this also damage or anything, any test reduction system through false smokes or any pulling MCP and choke notification signals or any other hand test for electrically driven maintain and hydrant, sprinkler, jockey pump, start valve, stop value and diesel driven pumps. So check all fire extinguisher are in correct place or expired or not, is healthy, checks or is okay or not. You check for every area and dents or corrosions in that fire equipments. And workplace attendance also mandatory, and strictly avoid the attendance through fingerprint based biometric machines. Instead of use your face expressions, face scanning biometric machines or wave based machine or visual inspections of all components for any kind of damage or loose connections. If body temperature screening camera not installed, then implement thermal face scanning solutions can be integrated with attendance solutions. There should be no overlap of shifts. A minimum time of one hour should be there between two shifts for cleaning to take place. So all this area you can be check for as per that Minister of Health guidelines. And you can be aware and awake about that posters and helpline and trainings and awareness, motivation is very, very important for this COVID-19 control methods. Every area and every department's heads also leading for this EHS guidelines. Posters with approved guidelines and messages must be displayed regular drill and training of employees must be conducted, maintaining 6 feet of distance. Can frequent announcement must be made in the floor to remind workers to mindful for their actions. You can contact numbers of government helpline must be displayed for your certain areas. So everything in every area before you can should be must and should be have to follow for this as per the DHS guidelines. And you can be wherever that in a cafeteria, for all this before enter the cafeteria you can follow the social distance number one, and face mask is mandatory, and your hands should be have to hand sanitize, and you have to follow the queue system for that in social distance, and no crowding for these things. And each, suppose if anything 4 tables is there, you have to sit for 2 tables only. So every in crowd movement you have to alert for the crowd movement, and you have to own, you have to individually have to realize, and instead of that going the cafeteria, you have to book that order for that even workplace area, and you take the ticketing system, you have to follow the ticketing systems. So to avoid the social distance and physical distance to without contact for that other persons. And you can be checked for that every 5 minutes for your Arogya Sethu app, if anybody in the nearest you that positive persons are, any positive areas or positive locations is there. In all cafeteria areas, and you can check for that as a facility manager, and you should, must should check for all vendor health status and their background checkups, and so there as per FSSA guidelines they followed are every food cooking sections and all counter areas and their food sampling area. So every area you should be checked for as a facility manager, you must and should be go for that kitchen walks and the kitchen rounds and kitchen audits as per Food Safety Standard of India. So each and every from farm to fork and raw material to from that your serving area, you can check for the all this area, raw material receiving area, production area, cooking area. So every area you should be focused for this your vendor evaluations. Then only you can be control methods is there, you can be address the control methods as per the FSSA recommendations. So for this cafeteria is very very mandatory for this as a workplace area without cross contamination through tools or any cafe etiquettes manner. So these are all the major area for this EHS guidelines for this in cafeteria. So any meeting, before meeting you can check and advise for authorities or community where you plan for that meeting or event, follow the advice. And face to face meetings you can avoid, and could it be replaced by teleconference or any virtual meeting is better. And you can pre order sufficient supplies or any materials including tissues or hand sanitizer for all participants, have a surgical masks available or not. And make sure all organizers or participants, caterers or visitors and event provide the contact details, mobile telephone number and their emails and their address and where he's staying. Okay, you can take for all details and their histories and their information, you can keep it for this health history. You know, better to have to avoid this COVID-19 positive symptoms for this checkpoints. Checkpoints is very very mandatory. And you develop and agree the response plan for case someone meeting becomes it will be the symptoms or COVID-19, dry cough or fever, or any identify a room or any someone who is feeling unwell or has symptoms can be safely isolated. So all new workmen, if anybody joined for new workmen, is a mandate for induction of the new workers. Staff should be avoided as far as possible. Worker staff from hotspot or potential risky area should not be inducted at site at all. If a new worker is coming to site, his background should be verified to know any history of illness, disease. Each new worker staff should be checked for any COVID-19 symptoms by qualified doctor, even if the information provided by him is satisfactory. So, and one more thing, gutka, tobacco, smoke is strictly prohibited in your workplace area as per that टोबैको कंट्रोल नाम्स एंड द यूज़ ऑफ गुटका एंड टोबैको प्रोडक्ट्स हैज़ बीन बैनड. इट इज़ ऑल्सो एनकरेज दैट एम्प्लॉइज गेट प्रिस्क्रिप्शन निकोटिन पैचेस आर गम्स टू अवॉइड स्मोकिंग स्मोकिंग एट पब्लिक प्लेसेज एनी वे अ पनिशेबल ऑफेंस एंड इफ कंपनीज हैव क्लोज स्मोकिंग रूम्स देन दे शुड बी क्लोज्ड as per that MHA you know issues and guidelines. So it should be every have to mandatory, and you can check for all before traveling and while traveling and return from traveling. Pro you can check for all COVID-19 symptoms before and after, and so every checkpoints is very mandatory for this in this scenario. And main focus as per Factories Act or OSHA's norms or building norms, NBC norms, NFPA, WHO, CPCB. So everybody merchant should be stated for that factories and any buildings or nucleuses prepare the accommodation to isolate the workers if needed. And HR is HSC and HR and help to manage all process for individual, all traveling employees also undergo the mandatory 14-day quarantine. And presence of the skilled workers and workers involved the dealing hazardous material must be skilled and experienced field. So no compromise or deployment such workers should be permitted when an industrial unit anything. So these are all environment health and safety guidelines as per that old health organizations. So every area they must and should be follow for that environment health and safety. So in this we have merchant should be aware and awake about that facilities management guys, administrative staff, health and safety environment staff, safety managers, all health workers. So every workers, soft services team and F&B team and technical team, engineering team, every persons merchant should be aware about that COVID-19 new norms and new rules as per that new guidelines for certain Minister of Health Welfare and World Health Organization's norms. If you habitually follow, then you definitely understand and implement your workplace area. So every not only HS person is responsibility, every department is taking the lead for this COVID-19 new norms without cross-contamination and without positive. So these are all the basic guidelines I had given the as per that environment health and safety guidelines. So after post lockdown you must and should be follow for this. These are all the guidelines and implement your area without any deviations. If you have any clarifications, please reach Health, Environment, Food Safety, Sustainability Solutions. My mail ID is that channelhaps@gmail.com. Thank you. Thanks a lot.